Yeah, early tomorrow morning, NASA, the French space agency, and SpaceX will send off the Surface Water and Ocean Topography, or SWOT satellite, from Vandenberg Space Force Base in Southern California. And as one scientist with NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory puts it, this mission is the missing link to fully observing Earth's water cycle.
So I like using the metaphor of when we go to the doctor and we take the pulse, you know, of the blood flowing through your vein, we'll be doing the same thing, but for Earth's arteries.
Those arteries, the streams, rivers, and reservoirs that make up all of the water on land.
You can think of it as, you know, the pulses of the water going down the river systems from the mountains all the way to the sea.
Continental freshwater makes up just 1% of all of the water on Earth's surface, but that 1% is the water supply for life. And NASA's SWOT satellite will give scientists and water managers the best view of that water they've ever had. SWOT will take measurements of the height of water on every patch of Earth every 21 days, beaming back high-resolution images of anything from oceans to the tiniest mountain streams. Those images will help scientists understand how surface water changes with time.
Once we are able to better understand how water flows, in the networks of rivers, lakes, and reservoirs around the world, we'll be able to better simulate that. And once you have better simulations, then you can project those into the future.
Those projections can help plan for the impacts of climate change by observing phenomena like sea level rise, droughts, and extreme flooding. This information can also help with pollution tracking, commercial shipping, and recreation. Stantec Consulting Services in Sacramento has partnered with the SWOT mission, and their hydrologists will be some of the first in the world to use its data.
We're hoping to be able to utilize the data to evaluate how climate change is going to affect sea level conditions throughout the world, including along the California coastline.
Senior Principal Hydrologist Jamil Ibrahim and the Stantec team have been doing this kind of work for decades, but data from SWOT will provide new and better insights.
The SWOT data are unique in the fact that they're going to be very high resolution at a scale that we haven't actually seen before.
And the first usable data from SWOT should come back about 6 months after the launch. The satellite is scheduled to remain in orbit for at least 3 years. NASA provides all of its data to anyone in the world for free, so scientists are hopeful that this technology can create more equitable access to the world's water supply.
Yeah,